Hey guys, so it's a pretty early morning here in Virginia. I tried my best to take some video this weekend of things that we were trying to accomplish. But sometimes you just don't have time to take video. I swear, everywhere I go, I have this ray of sunshine in my video. But I wanted to share some of the things that we've been working on here. We did pull up some bushes this weekend, which you probably saw me mention on Instagram. We moved some of the container gardens around, because they just weren't getting enough sun, and tomatoes like sun, so a lot of those needed to be moved. We planted a new front garden bed, which is, I like to refer to it as my medicinal garden. You hear that plane? Oh my goodness. And then believe it or not, we fit some fun in this weekend too, which I did not record. But so it was a fun weekend. I got to learn from the master. My husband is the master, in case you are unaware of that. He actually does landscaping and gardening for a living. And one of the things he's always told me from the beginning is that he wants me to do it myself because it's something that I enjoy and want to learn. And the only way to learn is to actually do it. So he's there for the questions that I have, but he's not there. He likes gardening, but not vegetable gardening. So that's a whole new thing for me. But he's big into hardscapes and landscaping and all those types of things. He does it for a living. He's also a handyman, an electrician, HVAC technician, so he does a lot of stuff and wears a lot of hats. But, so I got to learn from him this weekend. He taught me a few things that I didn't really know, and it's common sense, I think, but anyhow, I didn't get to capture that either, but I am going to do a blog post about that, because it's just easier for me to do that instead of grabbing my camera. And a lot of times he's like, why are you recording this? You have work to do. He's like, he doesn't understand the concept of YouTube. The only time he uses YouTube is when he needs to fix a vehicle, and that's when he's gracious for YouTube. Any other time he's like, how do people have time to do this? So anyhow, I just want to show you a few clips from our weekend. I'm going to show you a few clips from this week. A lot of you saw we had a bear adventure yesterday. It was quite the ordeal, but he came back again yesterday evening and we scared him off with some firecrackers. We have ratchet strapped our trash cans down, so that'll be helpful. We had stopped, we'd done that before, but we stopped because he just wasn't coming back. But we have apparently 3 or 4 bear in the area now that like to eat our trash. So we've taken care of that situation, hopefully. To answer your question, the game warden has not returned phone calls or come out yet. The only reason I called the game warden is because one of the bears is hurt and he's been attacking people's doors. Yeah, so this year is a really crazy year in Virginia for black bear. We've had a lot of wildfires, which caused them to be pushed down here at the foothills of the mountains. We don't live up in the mountains, we live in the foothills. And plus, I think they're just breeding like crazy this year. I mean, I called the sheriff's department yesterday, and they were telling me that they've had like 20 to 30 different bear sightings in the past 2 days. So we're just being very careful, taking precautions with that. I come out in the morning and bang pots and pans before I go down to feed the animals. And we're just very wary of letting Junior play outside by himself right now. Any other year, it's been fine. Bear have been really scared of us, but not this year. They're hungry and they're looking for shelter. Believe it or not, guys, fall's coming. So, all right, so I'm going to show you a few clips. I just quick snapshot a lot of them because, you know, we're busy. But you can see the quail are growing. The baby quail are actually getting ready to be moved to their own hutch so that they can finish out their growing period. They are fully feathered. The chicks that we hatched personally, they are all roosters, so they'll be going in a pot soon. And then the 2-hit chicks that Broody Mama hatched, I'm not quite sure what they are yet. because they have feathered out differently than the chicks that I hatched. The chicks I hatched are not, they're looking kind of ratty. The chicks she hatched are very smooth and they're beautiful. They're beautiful chicks. I wish I would have hatched more of our chicks because we've always had great success with how pretty they are. And I love the blue feathering that they have. So you'll see some of that. You'll see our baby rabbits. They're getting big. They're going to be ready for new homes soon. I have 3 girls and 1 boy. What are the odds of that? I was hoping I'd have 1 boy broken and 1 girl broken colors. But the only boy is the little black one, which you're going to see. He's a gimpy. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep him or not because apparently at some point, I think mama probably cleaning him off, she took off a piece of his paw. And that's why he's kind of just been kind of gimpy. But he's sweet as can be. He'll be a great pet for somebody. Otherwise, I'm going to hold back at least 1 of the females, possibly 2, and breed them as soon as possible to my current buck. And then I'll retire my buck and I will retire Esther. So they'll either be living their lives out here or looking for new homes, one or the other. I think that's it for me, guys. I'm going to show you some clips. I hope you enjoy them. Otherwise, have a great Thursday and a great weekend because I probably won't be able to post another video this week. I had every intention to. I think that's how it goes on YouTube. You have every intention to do it right. And you don't get it done because it's just one thing after the other. But so there you have it. Hope you guys have a great day. Talk to you soon. Happy homesteading. All right, homestead friends, I'm going to show you what we've been doing this week. You might remember that this whole line right here, it was all bushes. Those bushes unfortunately attracted really nasty, nasty worms. We have fought them every single year, and this year we decided not to fight them anymore. After all of that mess, I'm actually expanding my garden. What? I actually get to expand. So I brought some of these out here, the ones that weren't doing as well. Because reality is that we're surrounded by trees, and my tomato plants, some of them were not getting enough sunlight. So now this whole area is getting sunlight. So I've got some container gardens here. I've got some raised beds back there. More containers, more containers, more containers up there. More containers on the other side back here. I'm really excited about that. Let me show you our next project. So here is our next project. I'm really in love with it. This whole wall right here, my husband built with rocks that he's collected from various job sites that he's done. And look at this little guy. This is why we planted them. Not only is it a medicinal garden, it is also a pollinator garden. And because we don't have a lot of room here, we decided to take away some yard and plant some flowers. So in the back there we have, you guys know what those are black-eyed Susans. They're also called Rebecca. They're actually more efficient and better than Echinacea, which is what this is. These are purple cone flowers. We all know what that's good for. If not, it's good for flu and cold and boosting immunity. That's what these are good for too. They just do a better job at it. And this little flower, I got 2 of them. They're actually kind of new to me. I got them because they are pretty and pollinators love them.
but attainable, sustainable, say that 10 times fast. She was actually asking me about them. She's really knowledgeable in that stuff. And this is actually medicinal as well. This is called Speedwell. It's a hybrid of the Veronica plant. And this has medicinal purposes too. So I'm learning. I'm actually learning about this garden as we go. So I'm excited there. Now this is a question for you guys. See this? I haven't looked it up yet. I'm not quite sure what it is, but it's kind of taking over this tomato plant, unfortunately. It's a shame because we're getting some really nice tomatoes off of it. So any suggestions you have against that would be awesome. This is the sound of summertime, y'all. All that water. Check out this yard. Do you guys remember what this looked like just a few months ago?
And my hair is a mess today. I seriously haven't gotten my hair cut in like, I don't know, like 6 months? Probably more than that. Anyway.
Told you it was gonna fill in.
Hello, babies. Little quail babies are getting big. Go away, Mom.
I'm pretty sure all these chicks are roosters. These three are the ones that we hatched.
Hi.
Does the camera scare you? Believe it or not, these quail have actually been pretty docile.
Hi.
A lot different than the ones we bought as adults. They're doing good, but check out that little rooster back there. Mm-hmm. Looks like these guys are going into the pot soon.
Hi.
Check out these boogies. Look at them things. Look how big they're getting. Oh my goodness.
They're getting big.
They sure are. They're going to be ready for a new home soon. We are going to keep back two of them.
Hi.
Be ready to go. Their fur quality is excellent. This little black guy back here, do you remember me? I was telling you last time, he seems to kind of be not right, and I figured out why. Apparently he has a gimp leg. It was the first time we've ever had a little gimpy leg like that. Hi, baby.
What are you doing?
So he's gonna be a pet. We might keep him. We might find a good new home for him. We'll have to see. Hello, Mama.
Hi.
Free to good home he is. If you're near here in Virginia and you want a little black baby who's got a gimp leg, you're more than welcome to have him.
You're so cute.
Hi.
If I can show you.
Hello, Elizabeth.
Hi. No, I don't have any treats. But I don't. No treats today. Yeah. See my white hen back there? See those missing feathers right there? She's actually starting her molt. This is not uncommon for hens that are coming out of being broody. And so she has started her yearly molt. But Elizabeth has actually started her yearly molt as well. Elizabeth started early. You can see her back. Her back part.
Hi.
The back part of her feathers are missing, not because of rooster tread or anything like that, but because that's where she was attacked and she had a gash and we were able to nurse her back to health. So that's the part that's kind of filling in. You can see her brand new feathers are back there. Sorry, honey. Let's see if I can show you. Lizzie, come here. Come here. Okay. So her back feathers right here in this area, you can see they're a different color. They're a little bit lighter gray. And those are her brand new feathers that are coming in. The U.S. kind of have that lack for luster. They're a little bit like this. See how they're frayed? Hello, there you are. I was looking for you. Look at her beautiful new white feathers. The new white ones are coming in and the old brown ones are coming out. And it's been muddy because it's been raining every afternoon here. But she's got some new feathers coming in. Fluff butt. Not right. So everybody is starting their molt soon. Not everybody, not quite everybody. But they will be soon. Hey, Mama. Her bunnies are actually molting as well. Yep, bunnies molt. You see that tarnished brown fur on him? This is old blue. He's normally a really deep, deep dark blue. The brown is the old fur that's coming out, and the blue back in the back, the splotches that you can see, is the new fur that's coming in. So needless to say, right now he's a hairy mess, but so he kind of has a blowout every year, but he's doing good, aren't you? Aren't you? You don't care about me, do you? You don't care one bit about me. Hey! Hey! Get on! I still see you. You better go on. Get. Ah! Thank you.